With praise and thanksgiving, let us present our petitions. For the Church, may all her members be strengthened by the Holy Spirit and the universal call of holiness, we pray to the Lord. For government leaders, may God guide them in their efforts to protect the dignity and sanctity of life from conception through natural death, we pray to the Lord. For an increase of vocations, priesthood, religious life, and permanent life, especially for this church, we pray to the Lord. For all those who have died, and especially may we remember Bob and Alice, as we embrace our loved ones in this life, may God embrace them in eternal life, we pray to the Lord. God of all creation, we come before you this day, hear our petitions, and grant them according to your will, for we ask them through Christ our Lord. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread of life. Fruit of the earth, you are the human hands, and you become for us the bread of Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for your goodness we have received the wine we offer, fruit of the vine, Lord of human hands, it will become our spiritual bread. Pray, sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God and the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, we pray, the sacrifices instituted by your commands, and through the sacred mysteries which we celebrate in beautiful service, graciously complete the sanctifying work by which you are pleased to redeem us. Through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift, since our praises have nothing to your praise, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so we humbly with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim, Holy. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all peace. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending them your Spirit upon them like the moon, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly in his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you from heaven for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim the death. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of purity, together with Francis our Pope, the Lord's our Lord. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in their hearts. Welcome them to the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty God, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin, and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to our apostles, peace I give you, my peace I give you. Look not in our sin, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb of God. Grant us all, my Lord, that we may be refreshed and nourished by the sacraments which we have received, so as to be transformed into what we consume. Through Christ our Lord.
The Lord